Professor Dave here. Let's learn about enzymes.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We now know that proteins are polymers of amino acids. And since there are 20 amino acids in the body, and each protein has hundreds of amino acids, there are a mind-boggling number of possibilities for primary protein structure. This is how proteins can be so diverse and serve so many functions in the body. One type of protein is called an enzyme. An enzyme is a protein that serves some catalytic function in the body. Remember that a catalyst is something that lowers the activation energy of a reaction, and enzymes catalyze biochemical reactions. These are critical molecules for living organisms because nature can't do chemistry like we do chemistry in the lab. In the lab, we can throw anything we want into a flask and heat it up, cool it down, use strong acids and bases, or any number of strange exotic compounds. But inside your body, nature has to do chemistry at body temperature and neutral pH, only with the materials at hand and using only the reactions it has stumbled upon by blind chance over the past few billion years. Thus, the enzyme evolved. An enzyme takes a chemical reaction that would be nearly impossible inside the body and makes it up to a trillion times more favorable, such that it is feasible to occur on a normal biological timescale. So how do they work? Well, every enzyme has a specific substrate, and the enzyme recognizes its substrate with extremely high specificity. So it's kind of like a lock and key, where a specific molecule is the key that activates the enzyme's function. There is a specific area on the enzyme that the substrate will bind to, which is called the active site. The substrate will bind to the active site because it has just the right shape and composition to do so, meaning it is the right size, but it also has functional groups that make favorable electrostatic interactions with certain key residues in the active site of the enzyme. Whether those are van der Waals interactions, hydrogen bonds, or any other interaction of this type. The substrate might fit into the active site as is, or it might cause an induced fit, where the enzyme changes shape slightly once the substrate is inside. But either way, once the substrate is inside the active site and binding has occurred, a number of things might happen. One possibility is that the enzyme causes the substrate to bend in a particular way, which it will do in order to make certain interactions with the enzyme. And when in this bent configuration, some of the bonds become weaker and easier to break. This is one way the enzyme qualifies as a catalyst. The molecule would have a hard time breaking apart on its own, but in the conformation induced by the enzyme, the activation barrier associated with the reaction is much smaller. So many enzymes have the task of breaking down large molecules, like the ones we eat, to form the tiny components that we can use to build our own biomaterial. Once the enzyme catalyzes the reaction proceeds, the altered substrate leaves, and the enzyme can then go and catalyze another reaction. Enzymatic activity is always stereospecific, meaning that if a substrate can exist as two mirror images, only one of those forms will fit into the active site of the enzyme. Most enzymes have names that end in -ase, so you'll know an enzyme when you hear one. The rest of the name usually has to do with what the enzyme operates on. For example, the enzyme lactase breaks down lactose, the sugar found in milk, into two smaller sugars. We will learn about these types of molecules next. It is a deficiency in lactase that causes lactose intolerance in some people, because without enough of this enzyme, it is very difficult to digest lactose, as nothing is present to break it down once ingested. But breaking down molecules into pieces isn't the only thing that enzymes can do. Let's look at the categories. We already mentioned enzymes that break down molecules, and those could be a hydrolase, which catalyzes the hydrolysis of a chemical bond, which effectively separates a molecule into two pieces, or a lyase, which also cleaves covalent bonds, but by means other than hydrolysis. An enzyme with the opposite function, a ligase, is an enzyme that joins two molecules together. A transferase is an enzyme that transfers a functional group from one molecule to another. An isomerase catalyzes a spatial rearrangement of the substrate. And an oxidoreductase is an enzyme that transfers electrons from one molecule to another. Sometimes when an enzyme operates on its substrate, they will temporarily become covalently linked. This can happen if a residue in the active site has a nucleophilic group, like the hydroxyl group on serine, which can react with an electron-deficient atom in the substrate, kind of like an SN2 reaction. Sometimes an enzyme simply does acid-base catalysis, meaning it either donates a proton or accepts a proton from some functional group on the substrate to make it more reactive. An example of this is when a residue in the active site is acidic, like lysine, which, if protonated at the amino group, can donate this additional proton. Sometimes, in order to function, an enzyme requires certain cofactors or coenzymes. This is some other thing that must also bind to the enzyme before it can operate on the substrate. Cofactors are things like metal ions, whereas coenzymes are actual organic molecules like vitamins. That's why we need to get all our vitamins so that our enzymes can function properly. So you can see that there is a great variety of enzymatic activity, and all of it is biologically crucial. Certain enzymes break large molecules down into the small components we need for other enzymes to then build up all the biomolecules in our bodies, which is constantly happening in every cell in our bodies. We will come back to enzymes later, but for now, let's move on to some other biomolecules. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.